Good morning. In this last lecture, we have learned about magnetic field intensity of rotating stator and rotor is rotating, which is having one coil. So accordingly, we have ended up with this equation. We have ended up with this equations as this equations as HR1 minus HR2 plus HR3 plus minus HR4 equal to 0. From that HR4 equal to this HR4 equal to minus HR2, since these spaces are same, these two spaces are same, identical, and the current direction only different. Similarly, HR1 equal to minus HR3, or otherwise HR3 equal to minus HR1, and we have derived this or all the equations in this previous lecture. So then now, if we substitute, if we take this equation number 1, this is, you take it as equation number 2, then this is equation number 4 and equation 3 and equation number 4. So now, if we subtract n first equation and first equation from the second equation, we will have that first, if you subtract first second equation from this first equation, we will have, what is the value? HR4 minus HR1 minus HR1 plus HR2, we are subtracting. Therefore, we have NS into IS minus NR into IR divided by G. NR into IR divided by G. Already we know HR4 equal to minus HR2. HR4 equal to minus HR2. So that HR4 minus HR2, these two will be cancelled. So we can have this equation HR1 equal to NR IR minus NS IS divided by G. Similarly, if you subtract third, fourth equation from this third, we can end up with HR3 equal to NS IS minus NR IR divided by G. So it is concluded that HR1 equal to minus HR3. Then the another case, if you subtract first equation with third equation with this first equation, we have already all these conditions also apply these conditions HR3. If you subtract this, we will have HR4 equal to NSIS minus NRIR divided by G, divided by 2G. Then similarly, HR4. So we can, HR4 already we know. Therefore, minus HR2 equal to minus HR4, so that we can have HR2 equal to NRIR minus NSIS divided by 2 in the G. So now we are going to learn about that flux linkage of this coil, stator coil, flux linkage of the stator coil, phi s is equal to, we already know magnetic flux density B is equal to flux divided by area. So from this, flux is nothing but magnetic flux density in the area. So we can write double in the surface integral of B vector dot n cap in the ds. So now we already know B is nothing but mu naught in the h. Area we can write length in the radius of the radius of the coil, radius of this rotor, radius of stator or radius, so that we can write it as now mu naught in the radius, in the length, in the, we have to write this equation now in this way. In between, we are referring to stator. I already told you, we make it this alpha equal to 0. So this integral of alpha equal to 0 to this angle is theta. What is flux density? Hr3 into d alpha plus, this is magnetic field density. Then what about, this is returning path. If you take this is this is one direction, this is opposite direction. So sum of the magnetic flux density in the closed surface is equal to 0. So accordingly, we have to take any one of this area, either we have to take it this area or otherwise this area. If we combined all, total magnetic flux density is equal to 0, theta r, therefore integral of theta r to this angle to pi minus theta r. So we can have from alpha to theta r, from theta r to pi. This is a flux link, theta r to pi minus theta r. This is from here theta, already alpha, we have already taken this area. What is this area? Alpha equal to 0 to theta r, hr3. Now we have to take it in account this area. We have to take it in account, what is this area? Theta r to pi plus theta r, so that we can write theta r to pi plus theta r into, what is the magnetic flux density? hr4 into d alpha. hr4 into d alpha. So finally we will end up with mu naught into rl into h3 minus h4 into theta r plus mu naught rl h4 into pi, h4 into this angle of pi. So now we have ended up with this equation of pi. Then already we know what is mean by hr, this is also hr. Already we know what is mean by hr, what is mean by hr3, what is mean by hr4, and what is mean by hr3 and hr4. Accordingly, we have this equation as we have already, we can substitute one by one, we can finally end up with what is mean by the, what is the value of H flux in terms of a number of times. Just we can substitute accordingly. We can have already told you lambda phi s induced flux linkages in the stator is nothing but in the surface integral of b vector dot n cap into ds, b vector dot n cap into ds. Then already we end up with hr3 hr4, substitute hr3 hr4 everything, then we can substitute here. So we will have, I will write directly, mu naught into r into l ns minus nr divided by we will end up with this equation. If you substitute it, we will have ns is minus nr ir divided by 2g minus ns is minus nr ir divided by 2g the whole into theta r plus mu naught RL, already it is there. So we can have NS IS plus NR IR divided by 2G into pi. 2G into pi. So if you search now, what is mean by flux linkage of the stator lambda s is equal to NS into magnetic flux phi s. So then if you substitute NS here, we will have finally, we have the equation mu naught NS square R into L, R into L divided by 2G, divided by 2G pi into IS plus NS NR mu naught R L into pi divided by 2G into 1 minus 2 theta divided by pi into IR. This is the final values equation lambda which we have to substitute. So accordingly, we can take, this is the flux linkage of the stator, we can take this is LS, stator inductance. So then here also same thing with this, with respect to this theta R, we can take it as LM of theta. So now we can have LS into IS plus LM into LM of, LM is the function of theta R into IR. So now this is the stator flux linkage lambda L, LS into IS plus LM, LM into theta R. Now if theta R equal to 0, what is the value of LM? Theta R equal to 0, LM is nothing but mu naught NS NR R into L pi divided by 2G. Then if theta R equal to pi by 2, LM equal to 0. Then theta R equal to pi, we can have my LM is nothing but minus mu naught NS NR R L into pi divided by 2G. So like that, one can understand with respect to rotor angle how that inductance value is changing, mutual inductance value. This is called as self-inductance. The self-inductance is always constant. There is no variation of theta, but the mutual inductance, how it will be occur? We are writing the equation of the stator. So due to the current flowing through the stator, what is the flux linkages in, due to the current flowing to the rotor, what is the flux linkages in the stator? That is why we are getting this magnetizing inductance, mutual inductance. In this mutual inductance, based as the, this is also theta, as the theta R is increasing, you will have the waveform of this magnetic flux density, magnetic flux linkage as like this. This is the x-axis and this is our theta. So whenever theta equal to 0, magnetic LM will be maximum. Whenever theta equal to pi by 2, it will be minimum. Then whenever it will be minus pi, whenever this theta is pi, we will have, it will be minus LM. Accordingly, we have this equation is, curve is like this. Then again it will be goes and it will reaches to 180, it will be for 180 degree, it will be reaches to maximum. So from this we can conclude very easily that lambda is nothing but L into I. If the current is constant, lambda will varies like this. Like so, if we properly fix the slot of the coil and if you adjust the slot of the space of the coil, so you can make the flux linkages lambda is equal to L into phi will be the pure sinusoidal. Instead of this, we will get pure sinusoidal. Accordingly, we have to distribute the winding. We have to choose the distributed winding in this electrical machines. So with this, I would like to conclude today's lecture. I hope it is interesting and understandable. Wish you all the best. Thank you.